You might have used laughing gas, aka nitrous oxide, at the dentist's office. After all, it's the most common gaseous anesthetic in the world. Even the name sounds appealing. If you're walking into a situation that you know is about to be painful, just laugh it off. But laughing gas does more than just take away your pain at the dentist. Recent studies suggest it may treat the least funny thing imaginable, depression. There's an old saying that laughter is the best medicine, and one study published in 2012 put the adage to the test with a simple measure of pain tolerance. They used frozen sleeves and blood pressure cuffs on participants to create cold and restricted feelings, and measured how well they tolerated that unfun feeling. The researchers split the people into two groups, one that watched a video on something serious and another that watched something funny. As you might expect, the comedy group laughed more than the serious group. And when the researchers tested everyone's pain tolerance after watching the videos, they found that the group that watched clips from Mr. Bean or The Simpsons had higher pain thresholds and lasted significantly longer in those uncomfortable conditions than people who watched a lecture or the news. To paraphrase the great Elle Woods, laughter gives you endorphins, and endorphins make you happy. More specifically, endorphins bind to opioid receptors that block pain. And even though it doesn't actually force you to laugh, laughing gas is a great option for managing pain at the dentist. One huge benefit is that it works really fast. Nitrous oxide moves through your bloodstream without binding to hemoglobin or turning into anything else, so you can feel its effects quickly. When it gets to its destination, it hops off the bloodstream express and travels to specific sites on your brain cells called NMDA receptors and blocks them. This is similar to the way ketamine works, which makes sense because both nitrous oxide and ketamine are used as anesthetics. But the thing is, those NMDA receptors that nitrous binds to control a lot of your brain's activity, not just pain signaling. For example, some depression treatments also involve your NMDA receptors, which is getting today's researchers excited about a new therapeutic future for laughing gas on top of your teeth. Well, really above them and kind of behind them. It's your brain. I'm talking about your brain. And it looks like nitrous oxide makes a big difference in the brains of people with treatment-resistant depression. See, antidepressants don't work for about 20% of people with clinical depression, but a 2023 publication suggests that nitrous oxide can quickly do the job that other antidepressant treatments can't. In that study, participants diagnosed with treatment-resistant depression were all given face masks with either a nitrous oxide-oxygen mixture or an oxygen placebo. People who received nitrous oxide scored significantly lower on a depression assessment than the people in the placebo group. So nitrous oxide could someday be an effective treatment for people who've had trouble finding an effective antidepressant in the past. While researchers are still unpacking exactly why this one gas can do two different things, they have some ideas. See, the nitrous oxide group had more active functional connectivity networks than the placebo group, which basically means that more parts of the brain were communicating with each other. More specifically, it seems like the attention circuits in the brain were affected. So it's possible that nitrous oxide is manipulating your brain's attention circuits by increasing the activity and connection between different parts of the brain. Like when you use laughing gas, the attention-regulating frontal lobe might become more linked to other parts of the brain. And we know from previous studies that attention is controlled differently in people with depression diagnoses than in people without. So this nitrous oxide treatment might help remove the negative attention bias that some people with treatment-resistant depression have. Basically, it helps you stop focusing on bad stuff. And so far, things are looking good. Researchers are still testing if nitrous oxide can be used long-term against treatment-resistant depression, but the early reports are promising. For anyone who might be considering using nitrous oxide recreationally, though, a warning. In its unregulated form, the gas can leave you with long-term problems. When you have too much of it in your system, it can oxidize and inactivate vitamin B12, which can cause some gnarly neurological side effects. That's why dentists are careful not to overload your system with too much all at once. The professionals at your dentist's office give you nitrous oxide in low doses, mixed with a lot of oxygen to make sure you don't have too much of it in your body at any one time. So, as usual, it's best to take mind-altering substances under the supervision and recommendation of a trained medical professional. And once they finish conducting long-term safety tests, we might be saying that laughing gas is the best medicine.